In this tutorial series, I'm going to show you how to use iMovie to create a video. For this tutorial, I'm using version 10.1.1. In part one of the series, I will introduce you to the iMovie workspace and show you how to import media. Let's start with the iMovie workspace. When you open iMovie, you will see three possible views. Your media library with links to your iPhoto library, and to your iMovie library, which contains video files you've added called events. Highlight one event and you can see all the clips that have been added. To create a new event, go to File and select New Event, and a new event will appear in your iMovie library, and you can add some text to give it a title. The next tab takes you to the project library, where all of your movie projects will be listed. The final tab takes you to the iMovie Theater, which is where you can view high-quality versions of your movies or clips. It's built to work with iCloud, so that movies you send to the theater automatically appear on all your other devices. To create a new project, click the plus sign. You have a choice of movie or movie trailer. We'll select movie. Next, we have a choice of themes. For now, I'll use a blank theme. Click Create and you are prompted to name your project and to select which library to store it in. I've already created a project called Test Movie. Once your project is created, iMovie presents you with a three-panel workspace. Your project library is in the upper left-hand panel where you can access your media files. To the right is the Viewer panel, where you will preview the video project as well as your media. The lower panel is the timeline, where your media will be sequenced. Note that you can resize these panels to suit your preferences. Now let's look at how to import your video footage. Select the event in your library, or create a new one to import to. You can select File and Import Media, or you can select the down arrow. This opens up your file directory on your computer. Select the media file and click Import Selected. You can also import from an attached device such as an iPad or camera. I've got my iPad connected to my computer through a USB cable. Under Cameras, I see all connected devices and I select my iPad. Now I can see all video clips on my iPad. I can select one and preview it by tapping the space bar on my keyboard. To import, I click Import Selected. You'll use the same procedure to import media from other devices or cameras. Once connected to your computer, they should appear in the list of cameras. In the second part of this tutorial, we'll start building a new video project using our imported files.